Introduction. The chapter develops cybersecurity and the possible cyber attacks that the charging points of the fleet's electric vehicles may have, their consequences and the measures to be adopted to prevent and avoid them. Index. Cybersecurity of charging points. Electric vehicle charging stations. Types of cyber attacks that the charging station can suffer. Cybersecurity recommendations. Cybersecurity recommendations, VSOC. Communications. Physical access. The QR code scam at Tesla charging points. Implications for fleet management. Subscribe to the fleet management channel. Your subscription is a great support to continue making new videos. Subscribe. 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 Cybersecurity of charging points. Recharging points. Since charging stations and points are managed by internet-based systems, they face unique problems such as cybersecurity attacks. Among the most serious are the theft of user information and payments with fake cards made by crackers, but there are many more. For this reason, numerous studies are being carried out that, in addition to highlighting these vulnerabilities, try to solve them. One of the most recent has just been published by researchers at the University of Texas at San Antonio. Theft of personal data and even blackouts. The director of the UTSA Cybersecurity and Analysis Center, Elias Buharb, and his colleagues from the University of Dubai, Claude Fashka, and from Concordia University in Montreal, Tony Nasser, Sadiq Torabi, and Chadi Asi, sign one of the studies most recent and interesting about the vulnerabilities of the cyber systems that equip the vast majority of charging stations for electric vehicles and how to protect them. Together with his team, Elias Buharb has identified up to 16 different vulnerable electric vehicle charging management systems, which they divided into categories such as firmware applications, mobile applications, and websites to perform detailed in-depth security analyses of each one of them. Among the security vulnerabilities found in these systems that they consider most serious are the lack of security in authentication and cross-site scripting, or XSS, which can be used to steal sensitive information, hijack user sessions, or even compromise the browser used, subjugating the integrity of the system. These investigations follow the line of others carried out by programming experts such as Matthias Dahlheimer, who already in 2018 demonstrated that it was possible to use a fake credit card to charge your electric car by transferring the cost to the original car, duplicating one of yours to prove it. Not only that, but it also tested that on some charging stations with USB port, it could copy the configuration data and logs of the station. Consequences on the electrical network. The scientific article, Public Plug-in Electric Vehicles Grid Data. Is a new cyber attack vector viable? Conducted by researchers from the Tandon School of Engineering in New York, concluded that, with 1,000 electric cars charging simultaneously, a huge blackout could be caused in Manhattan. And the charging stations are connected to the electrical supply of cities, and according to the research, each vehicle that uses a public charging station generates data on its location and charging time, along with information on average energy consumption per hour at each station. This information is easily accessible to hackers and crackers, as it is transmitted wirelessly through third-party applications installed on the smartphones of electric vehicle owners. Thus, if a cracker managed to access that information, he could manipulate the demand at a particular charging station, and it would be possible to destabilize the network and leave entire neighborhoods without supply. To avoid a massive attack on the electrical grid, UTSA researchers recommend developers patch existing vulnerabilities as soon as possible, but also incorporate initial security measures during the manufacturing of the charging stations.
Learn about our fleet management consulting and training services. Reduce costs and optimize fleet management activities. We electrify your fleet of vehicles. We carry out the electrification plan until its implementation, known as
electric vehicle charging stations. Architecture of electric vehicle charging stations. Before knowing the security measures that charging stations must implement, it is advisable to know the architecture that makes up these stations and their main elements, the charging points, the CPO charging point operators, and the distribution system operators, DSO. The functions performed by the charging point are: 1. Provide and control the energy exchange between the electric vehicle and the charging station thanks to the use of the EVIS component, electric vehicle supply equipment, whose function is to supply electricity to the vehicles. 2. Collect specific information about the measurements marked by the meter in each charge of an electric vehicle. 3. Establish appropriate authentication mechanisms to identify and authorize electric vehicle users to charge it. 4. Activation of remote capabilities. For example, adjustment of the maximum power allowed by the charging point to the charging point through the local controller component over 1. The role and functions of the loading point operators are: 1. Provide permissions to the electric vehicle user to charge. 2. Collect data, processes, and measurements. 3. Control the flow of energy allowed between the charging point and the electric vehicle based on the data provided by distribution system operators. 4. Ensure the stability of the power source. 5. Provide connection to charging point operators. 6. Connect the charging point operators. The role and functions of the distribution system operators are: 1. Forecast available capacity. 2. Ensure the stability of the power source. In the proposed architecture, you can see how an electric vehicle connects to the charging station through a specific connector defined by IEC 62196. Once connected, the user must identify themselves at the authentication terminal using a mobile application with specific RFID cards, etc. This authentication will allow the charging point to go into operation to supply and control the energy sent to the car for charging. To let the user know when the car is charged, panels within the charging station itself, notifications from mobile devices, etc. are usually used. Types of cyber attacks that the charging station can suffer. Below are some examples of possible cyber attacks. One of the big problems is the existence of security vulnerabilities in the devices that make up the station. Since, due to its location, in most cases, it can only be updated by physically moving to the place where said station is located. The most found vulnerabilities in this case are the lack of security in authentication and XSS cross-site scripting, which could be used to obtain sensitive information, compromise the browser being used, or even be able to hijack sessions of user. Sometimes charging stations have USB ports, which would lead to being able to carry out different attacks, such as introducing a specially designed pen drive, which can send a discharge of very high voltages, destroying the charging station device, or even copying the configuration data and records of the station. Another problem is that these stations are connected to the internet. In order to send and receive information, it is very important to use cybersecure protocols, since if the protocols used are not secure, it could cause the information transmitted to be obtained by the person carrying out the attack. Remote threats can be launched through the communication systems that these stations have, either because they are connected directly to the internet through fiber optics, or through 4G, 5G. Susceptibility to signal injection attacks at the physical layer. PLC power supply communication, used in standardized charging systems, such as the Combined Charging System, CCS, and the North American Charging Standard, NACS, allows simultaneous transmission of data and power over the same power lines. However, unshielded charging cables can act as susceptible antennas, allowing attackers to intercept communication packets between charging stations and EVs, or even maliciously suspend charging sessions. Remote access to charging stations. Remote access is essential for maintenance and troubleshooting, but it also introduces several vulnerabilities. Using default or shared credentials can lead to unauthorized access, compromising the security of the shipper's entire network. In many cases, the lack of encryption for data at rest or in transit allows attackers to intercept or modify information, while the absence of network security measures, such as segmentation and the use of VPNs, IDS, or firewalls, makes it easier for an attacker who compromises a single station to access the entire network. An emerging threat is the broken wire attack, which specifically targets the CCS system used for direct current fast charging in electric vehicles. This attack leverages the carrier sense multiple access with collision avoidance CSMA/CA mechanism to disrupt control communication between the vehicle and the charging infrastructure, abruptly terminating charging sessions. What sets broken wire apart is its wireless execution using electromagnetic interference, allowing attackers to remotely disrupt individual vehicles or entire fleets using commercial radio hardware and with limited technical knowledge. Types of cyber attacks that the charging station can suffer. After knowing the different types of cyber attacks that can be carried out, it is also very important to be able to know the risks and problems that this can entail, such as, for example, electric cars can be infected through the charging station. This can be a big problem, since it can affect the proper functioning of the car, and therefore, it would affect the safety of people, both those inside the vehicle and outside. Another problem to consider is the data used at these stations. Since very sensitive information is used, such as user ID, bank cards, etc., what the attacker could obtain said information and be able to impersonate the identity of the user who uses said charging station. Charging stations, especially those located in urban areas or those installed in the parking lot of homes, are usually connected to the same lines that are used to provide electricity to buildings. So if any type of loading is carried out that has not been contemplated, it can lead to big problems. For example, there are studies that document that if several charging stations are operating at the same time, they can affect the electricity in homes, creating voltage surges and dips, which would affect all the electronic devices in the buildings. This is a big problem, since sometimes you can have control of all the charging station outlets and have them work at the same time. Cybersecurity recommendations. If we want to guarantee the safety of electric charging stations or points, we must approach safety from several different points. Security in communications between the charging point and the charging point operators must be guaranteed, so that they cannot be intercepted or altered by third parties. Perform code analysis. Both the mobile applications developed to interact with the electric charging point and the software implemented in the station that will interact with said mobile application. Physical access to the device must be secured, so that it is not possible to extract any of its internal components, especially components that may contain a microprocessor or memories. Firmware updates must be supported, so that any vulnerability detected can be corrected. Integrate some solution into the devices so that they can detect if they are in the USB ports. The pen drives used are free of infection. Integrate EDR endpoint detection response systems. This will allow if there is a problem within the device, it can be detected as soon as possible and solved. Use protocols that are cyber secure and have encryption mechanisms, such as the HTTPS protocol instead of HTTP. Cybersecurity recommendations VSOC. The establishment of a Vehicle Security Operations Center, also called VSOC, is essential to guarantee the security of charging stations. A centralized VSOC, Vehicle Security Operations Centers, provides advanced monitoring, detection, and incident response capabilities, enabling comprehensive cybersecurity management across the charging station network. A VSOC consists of a series of centralized facilities where the safety of a fleet of vehicles is monitored and responding to safety incidents that arise. As the level of vehicle connectivity and the risk of a cyber attack increase, VSOCs become an indispensable tool. One of the main advantages is that they allow fleets to be monitored centrally, which means security teams can monitor the security status of all vehicles in a fleet from a single location. By monitoring the entire fleet, safety teams can identify patterns and trends that indicate the presence of a potential safety issue. Another advantage of a VSOC is that it allows monitoring and response to occur in real time. VSOCs have advanced monitoring tools capable of detecting security incidents as they occur. Thanks to this, security teams can respond quickly and correctly to security incidents they face, thus minimizing the impact they could have on the fleet and its operations. The professionals in charge of these VSOCs must be highly qualified. To be able to monitor the security of a fleet of vehicles and respond to any possible security incident. However, the automotive sector currently does not have enough qualified professionals, making it difficult for organizations to establish and maintain a VSOC. Through the implementation of monitoring systems based on obtaining telemetry from all charging stations, the VSOC can contextualize and analyze data in real time to identify anomalous activities or suspicious behavior that may indicate that a cyber attack against that infrastructure. This capability not only encompasses individual charging stations, but extends to large-scale distributed networks. Proactive monitoring allows us to detect unauthorized access attempts and respond immediately with cybersecurity specialists to any security vulnerability, thus maintaining the integrity and availability of the charging infrastructure. Even when a vulnerability in the infrastructure is known, VSOC may act to patch the systems or apply security controls that prevent a cyber attack from being carried out. To implement a VSOC in the fleet, a managed service provider, MSP, in cybersecurity can be hired. MSPs are specialized firms that offer a range of cybersecurity services, including threat detection and response, vulnerability management, and compliance management. MSPs have extensive cybersecurity experience and are equipped with advanced tools and technologies that help identify and respond to security incidents more quickly and effectively. Additionally, MSPs also offer a broader view of the threat landscape and can provide valuable insight into threats and trends. Another reason companies partner with MSPs is to reduce costs. Additionally, building and maintaining a VSOC, along with other internal cybersecurity capabilities, can have a high financial cost. However, by partnering with an MSP, companies can benefit from their infrastructure and resources, thereby reducing the overall cost of their cybersecurity program. Finally, by partnering with an MSP, companies can demonstrate to their customers, partners, and regulators their level of commitment to cybersecurity. MSPs are often certified to industry standards and can help companies achieve and maintain optimal compliance with applicable regulations, such as the General Data Protection Regulation and the United Nations Regulation on cybersecurity and software updates. In order to guarantee the above security points, electric vehicle charging stations should follow the following recommendations and security measures, both in their communications and in physical access.